Hello, everyone. Let us now learn about the total return swap, or the TRS. In this swap, one party pays a fixed or a floating rate of return in exchange for the total return generated by a reference asset. The reference asset can be an equity share, a bond, an index, etc. The total return includes all sorts of income and returns generated by the asset, that is, coupons, dividends, and capital gains. Let us see an example to understand the functioning of a total return swap. Suppose Tina and Lily enter into a one-year total return swap in which Tina will pay a fixed rate of 6% to Lily, and Lily will pay the total return generated by her equity shares of Walmart. The notional principal amount is taken as $1,000. Instead of using a fixed rate payment, we can also use a floating rate payment, such as LIBOR. We know that it is very difficult to determine the potential gains from equity investments, and one can only take a guess. Though Walmart usually pays a dividend, the share price can go up or down. Thus, the overall return could be positive or negative. Using the total return swap, Tina is able to get an exposure on Walmart without actually investing in the equity of the company. She feels that Walmart will generate total returns of around 10%, and she will benefit from the swap. Lily feels that this year, the share price of Walmart will decrease, and the total return will be lower than 6%, say around 3%. As she will receive 6% from Tina as per the agreement, the swap will benefit her. Thus, as we can see, both of them are having a different opinion on how Walmart will perform this year. Suppose, this year, the share price of Walmart increases by 9% and the dividend yield is 2%. Thus, the total return will be 11%. Let us understand how the swap will be settled in this scenario. If we talk from Tina's perspective, she has to receive 11% from Lily and pay 6% to her. We can net this payment and say that Tina has to receive 5% from Lily on the settlement date. 5% of $1,000 is $50, so Tina will receive this amount from Lily. Here is the payoff from Lily's perspective. Pause here to take a look. If the total return generated by Walmart is only 4%, then Tina has to receive $40 from Lily and pay $60 to her. This payment can be netted and Tina will pay $20 to Lily. Pause here to take a look at the calculations. Let us now see an interesting scenario. What happens if the share price of Walmart goes down and it generates a negative total return of 4%? What do you think will happen on the settlement date? Pause the video here and solve this scenario. So here is the answer. Tina has to pay 6% and Lily has to pay minus 4%. But how can someone pay minus 4%? Well, surprisingly, in this case, Tina will have to compensate Lily for her loss, and she will pay 6 minus minus 4%, that is 6 plus 4 or 10% to settle the swap. Thus, using this swap, Lily is able to mitigate the risk of her equity investment losing its value. If her investment generates a negative return during the year, Tina will compensate her for the loss along with the fixed rate payment. Isn't this swap just wow? However, as this is an OTC agreement, both parties are exposed to default risk, that is, the losing party defaulting on his commitment. Investment banks, hedge funds, and other financial institutions are the major users of such swap agreements.